Welcome back. In the previous videos, I looked at installing Active Directory. In this video, I will look at removing Active Directory. In the simplest case, this involves demoting a domain controller back to a member server. This will cleanly remove the domain controller from the domain. When possible, you should use this approach. As long as there are other domain controllers in your domain, making sure at least one is a global catalog server, you can add and remove domain controllers from the domain as often as you like. If, however, the domain controller is the last domain controller in the domain, this will remove the domain entirely and with it the Active Directory database for that domain. If the domain is a child domain, the root domain and other child domains will still function as normal. Removing child domains is a common practice when you migrate users from child domains to the other domains. Perhaps the child domain was created due to a previous limitation or for reasons that no longer exist, and thus the decision was made to merge domains together. The process of changing a domain controller back into a member server or standalone server is called demoting the server. To demote a domain controller, the same tool is used as to promote it, DC promo. In some cases, the domain controller hardware may have failed and you will not be able to run DC promo. If this is the case, refer to our other video on seizing operation master roles to see how to manually remove a failed domain controller from Active Directory. Before you decide to demote your domain controller, check to see if the domain controller is holding any of the operational master roles. The quickest way to do this is to run the command NetDom query FSMO. If an operational master role is present on the domain controller, DC promo will automatically transfer the role to another domain controller. It is best to manually move the operational master role yourself if you want to control to which domain controller the operational master role goes. See our previous video on how to move operational master roles around. Before you remove the domain controller, you should next check that you have enough global catalog servers in your domain. You have to have at least one, but you should always have more for redundancy. Also, consider what effect removing a global catalog server will have on your network. Clients that are using that global catalog server will instead have to go to a different global catalog server. If this global catalog server is over a WAN link, this can have a big effect on response time to the clients. In this video, I will remove the last domain controller from a child domain. This will effectively remove the domain from the forest. Before doing this, you should understand that this will remove the Active Directory database and along with it, anything stored in the database. This includes certificates, group policy, and user and computer accounts. You should ensure that you have exported everything that you need before retiring the domain. What I like to do before removing a domain like this is to shut down the last domain controller for a week or so beforehand. This should be long enough to find any problems that may have been missed before removing the domain completely. I will now change to my Windows Server 2008 domain controller to demonstrate how to remove a child domain. Before I demote this domain controller to a member server and effectively remove the East ITFreeTraining domain, I want to check if any operational master roles are present on this domain controller. To do this, I will run netcom query FSMO from the command prompt. Since this is the last domain controller in the domain, all the domain-wide operational master roles will be on this domain controller. I have also transferred the domain naming master and schema master forest-wide roles to this domain controller as well. When the server is demoted, the schema master and domain naming master will automatically be moved to another domain controller. You should, however, perform this step yourself to have some control over to which domain controller these operational master roles will be moved. To demote the domain controller to a member server, I will run DC promo from the start menu. Once I get past the welcome screen, I will get a warning telling me this domain controller is the global catalog server. Before you demote a domain controller, you should ensure that you have enough global catalog servers on your network. On this screen, you are given a tick box asking if this is the last domain controller in the domain. In this case, this domain controller is. You would also tick this box if you had failed domain controllers that you were not bringing back online again, and this was the last functional domain controller. Be aware that by ticking this box, you are effectively removing this domain and the Active Directory database completely. This includes users, computers, keys, and group policies, anything that has to do with this domain. If you have keys like EFS keys stored in Active Directory, you should export these keys first. On the next screen, you need to enter in a username and password for an administrator in the Enterprise Admin group. Since this is a child domain, changes need to be made in the root domain as well to ensure the root domain knows the child domain is being removed. The next screen will ask you for a local administrator's account password. Remember that when you promote a server to a domain controller, the local accounts database is disabled. In order to access this server once it is demoted, you will need this administrator's password. That's it. Once you press Next on the summary screen, this domain controller will be demoted to a standalone server, and this domain and Active Directory will be removed. The process took just over a minute on this server. Large domain setups will take longer. I will skip forward in the video to the end of the wizard. Once the wizard is complete, Windows will ask to reboot the server. After the reboot, you will need the administrator's password that you entered in the wizard to access the server. That's it for removing domains and demoting domain controllers. In the next video, I will look at trusts. Trusts in a multi-domain environment allow your users to access resources in other domains seamlessly. Thanks for watching this free video in this completely free course on Active Directory. See you next time.